Hello everyone, welcome to episode 5. In this episode we're going to be dealing with the insertions. So for example, at the beginning of your scenario you might want to have your player parachuted into an area or from a plane, or maybe you want to have him get into the passenger seat of a heli, the heli then fly to another area, land, drop him off, and then fly off back to the beginning point of where you got in the heli. That's what I'm going to be teaching you how to do in this video. So let's get started. We're not going to be using strange bedfellows. We're going to be just using just two mods, Eden Enhanced and Eden Extended Objects, but they're not necessary for playing a mission scenario. So they're more for helping you with mission creation. They're very useful. So we're going to go to Altis, I think. Okay, so it's just just gonna move that camera to there because I'm gonna use this as the insertion area. I'm just gonna do a couple of things. I'm gonna put a helipad down. So as you can see, it's props. Signs, helipads. So I'm just going to put a helipad there. Just straighten it up. Because this one's going to be visible. So for the other part of the other type of insertion, I'll be making another helipad at another location. That one I'll be making invisible. Right. I'm also going to put first. I'll put down my our player, so there he is. Just going to give him his this. So I've gone through all this in episode 1, setting up the character. So he's got his call sign, and I'm just going to make it so he doesn't have stamina enabled. Okay. So of course you can edit the loadout. I'm not really going to bother, I don't think, because that's just going to take up time. Okay. So we want him to arrive in a plane and then get parachuted out. So can't use any of those. So we're going to go into Pacific. Actually, what have we got in here? Anything? ArmA are going to have anything. So we're going to use the Blackfish infantry transport. I'm just going to right click on it, edit appearance, just change the colour. That's all you can do actually with this. Unfortunately you can't do anything like turn off the lights on or anything like that. So I've made sure that this has got a bunch of people in it already. I could also have a load more, but I don't want to. Our player's already got his unit, because his unit is BBA. So if I stuck a load more guys in, they wouldn't all parachute out. It'd just be me, because that'll be in the code. Basically, it's going to be so this. Oh, I want to give this a name as well, a variable name. No, it's just going to be plain one. Just do so it's easy to remember what it is. I'm going to give it a move waypoint to there. It will drop him, but it won't drop him exactly on, it'll drop him over here somewhere probably. And then another move waypoint, and then we're going to have it fly back off over here somewhere. So just go back, I want to get this off the ground. You could have this take off from somewhere else if you wanted to, but I'm going to start off already flying. Okay. Direction. So I could have it coming from up that way. Okay, so now this first move waypoint, just going to double click it. We're going to go down to here on activation, and we want to type in BBA, because that's the unit name for our player. Leave vehicle plane 1, semicolon, open squiggly brackets, underscore X space action space open square black bracket quote eject with a capital E close quote comma vehicle space underscore X square bracket, close square bracket, colon, close squiggly bracket as well. And then for each, that's one word with a capital E for each, units, and then our unit, and then semicolon. Can have it do it fast. Have it do it however you want. Okay. Oh, one thing we got to do first, though. This is kind of important. We got to give our guy a parachute because that didn't work. It didn't load out. Right. So we've got to change his backpack to a steerable parachute. So I'm going to press S. Steerable parachute. Okay, now he's okay to drop. Okay, so I'm just going to test it out. Oh, I want. This isn't necessary, but this is something I would do because. Why is he dropping in here? He's dropping in here because there's a vehicle that he's got to get. So I'm just going to put that down. Down like that. I'm just going to right click on it. This is actually giving it a specific colour. It's quite useful for if you're doing cinematics, because you're going to have to do a lot of takes. Every time you press the play scenario button, it would change colour because it would go with one of the random colours. So you can have that sitting there. Okay, let's do a test, shall we? So it's kind of a, it's not exact Well, unless you opened the parachute as soon as you went out the door, maybe, I don't know. So maybe there's gear in the van, who knows. Okay. Right, so for the second part, we're going to get me out of the out of this. See that island over there? That's where we're going to be starting. So I'm going to grab him and hold down the both mouse buttons so I've got him and I can rotate, and then I'm going to shift W just to get over to this island. I think I want to be over this side. This would do. Yep, so there we go. Right, so this part's going to be a little bit more complicated than the other one, but it's going to be fun. Let's say give him a bag, passenger bag. So we're going to have him starting in here, facing, I don't know, let's have a look. Actually in the floor, so just going to raise him up. Right. Okay. Now, I'm going to put a couple of soldiers outside. They're just going to be standing there, but they're going to have animations attached to them to make them a little bit more interesting. They're not going to be linked to him either. If you don't mind, thank you. Have this guy, he's going to be complaining because he hasn't got enough ammo, so I'm going to make sure he doesn't. See, oh, he's got three, he should be okay. He's got three mags. I think it's over two. If they got two or less, that's when they start complaining. So I'm going to have him standing against this wall. I'm going to double click on him. Now this is where Eden Enhance comes in. So I'm going to have him just lean. There we go. You can actually do this by just typing into here. Like for this, it'd be open square bracket this comma space quote sit underscore low all capitals close quote comma space quote as is all one word close quote in all in capitals again close square bracket call underscore bis in capitals underscore fnc underscore ambient anim capital A on anim all one word semicolon. That would basically say that this guy has to have this pose, but his inventory and everything is as is, so whatever he's been given. So you could have a marksman standing talking to this guy. Just give him a little bit of distance. And we give him one of the standing ones with the weapon. Or or if there was a table or something there, they could he could be leaning against the table. Okay, I don't want this episode to be any longer than necessary, because that was that's been one of the bugbears for me on the whole series so far, is too much faffing about. I want this to be concise and to the point, because it's more helpful to people that way. Right, so putting down a helipad. This one I'm going to be making invisible, but not right now. Okay, so we're going to use helicopter. Just use one of these M900s. We're going to choose the colour. So do and have long treads on it, doesn't really matter. Okay, so we've got these guys already sitting there, so I'm going to click on the pilot and I'm going to put a waypoint down of load, just stick that there, and then on our guy, our player, we're going to have a get in. Just going to click that on there, and then we're going to right click on the load waypoint, set activation waypoint activation, and then link it to the get. Oh damn, that's the wrong. Should be get in, not get out. I clicked the wrong thing. There we go. That's okay, because I've changed it. Then after that, on the load one, we're going to continue that with transport unload, which basically tells it any passengers will be dropped, and we're going to put that on that helipad on the other island. But we want to go and have a look at this, and then have it. We're going to have a get out, and we're going to bring that back here and put that on the helipad. Now, there's a couple of things we've got to do to those last two waypoints. I'm going to do it to this one first. Just going to have this in combat, and I also want to make sure that it's actually on the ground. Right there. Yeah. Yeah, get out. There we go. So that's right on the ground now. It's right on the helipad, in the centre of the helipad virtually. Yeah, it is in the centre of the helipad. You can see the orange square. So we're just going to go here to the other one, because this is really important to have these on the ground and also have them in combat, because unfortunately the way this works, there is another one you can have it as careless, but unfortunately with careless it doesn't seem to work. Well, sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't, whereas with combat it seems to be more reliable. It's kind of stupid, but that's how it is. So so I'm gonna make this the player, just so we can observe the whole thing. So the player might act kind of strangely, because you know this is ArmA 3 AI. He might go prone for no apparent reason. Take a long time to work out where the flaming helicopter is. Yeah, no, he didn't. If he had a pistol, he would have gone prone. There you go, he's in. Helicopter starts up. Oh, didn't show you those guys, did I? See there. there's a reason I didn't pick him or me as the player, was because otherwise I'd have to do another test so I could see if the next waypoint's working. There's the truck with the door open, and all the back doors open, the side door open as well. Loading door. I'll put the script in the description for the paratrooper thing. As soon as it lands, he'll be out. There he goes, and then we're off again. So it's kind of, it barely touches the ground. There he is, standing by the van. So the pilot will get out. I won't, obviously, because I'm a player rather than. Rather than an AI, so I have to do that myself. I forgot to show you how to make that invisible. Well, I think I showed you in previous episodes, but I'll make that invisible. I could actually change it to an invisible one, or I could make it not show model. I think the reason that's all distorted is because we haven't got radios. Supposed to be hearing him chatting over the rotor blades, I say, I'm not sure. You watch him get out before the helicopter's even down. See, the engine's off. So there's these guys just having a nice casual chat. So they could have been civilians, the helicopter pilots, because sometimes if you're using, say they were like they are, and if I'd given me or any of these guys and any of these civilian guys weapons, things might have played a bit different. Because they will kind of hesitate, and like the helicopter might have flown around the island instead of flying to its waypoint. Anyway, yeah, let's just show you quickly. There's two things I could do for this helipad. Oh crap. There we go. I could either and that's the second one, isn't it? The first one's I could either change it so it's an invisible one like that, or just put it back to what it was, or I can do this, because this is basically what the other one does anyway. Don't show model. So I just disabled show model. Now this won't show up until I click on that. There you go. There's no helipad showing. It's still there, but it's not showing. Right, okay, I hope this was useful. Thanks for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next episode, which we'll be doing extraction. Bye for now.